Hey, Jordan here. A/B testing is a really useful design tool, but it can sometimes seem kind of expensive or intimidating. Thankfully, there's an app from Google called Optimize that makes A/B testing really easy and totally free. And today we're gonna walk through a real world example of how to use it on your next design project. Let's say we're a product designer at a tech company that makes a podcast app. Our analytics are showing that when users pull up the app, they're not sticking around for very long. So we have a goal to increase session times. We've done some user interviews and we figured out that one of the main problems might actually be the main navigation of the app. It's kind of bland and uninteresting and not very helpful. We think that if we make some adjustments to the main nav, that could have a big impact on session times. So that's our hypothesis, and now we need to go run an experiment to see if it's true or not. Now, just a note on Optimize, we're on the free plan here, which is really generous and more than enough for pretty much anyone. Here's what our dashboard looks like. It's just a list of our experiments. And before we get everything running, we need to set up a couple things. First, we gotta link our Google Analytics account to Optimize because that's what Optimize uses to measure what happens in the experiments. We also have to install the Google Optimize snippet on our website, and it really helps to install the Chrome extension, which we'll talk more about later. And with that, we're all set up and ready to go, so let's create our tests. We can go to Create an Experience. Let Optimize know the URL of our app. Give it a name. I like to name it based on the hypothesis. And select the type of test that we're doing, which is just an A/B test. Now, there are 23 steps to make an A/B test broken out over 14 pages. Nope, I'm just kidding. There are only 5 steps, and they're all right here on this one page. In step 1, we need to create the variant. So this is the new version of the app that we're going to test. So I'll click Add Variant and name it based on what's different about it. And here's where the Google Chrome extension comes into play. When you click Edit, it brings up that page we specified before and gives us a really easy visual way to set these changes on the variant. So you can choose the device you're previewing with and test with different screens. You can find things based on their HTML and CSS. You can move things around by clicking and dragging. You can change the UI design using the box in the bottom right. It's called the editor palette. You can change things like typography, colors, even dimensions, and move things around. You can change the HTML or even JavaScript directly by clicking on the Edit Element button. So we've actually got a brand new design for the nav that I'm just gonna insert here. It's got a bunch of new links that you just hover to reveal. We're going to click Save and Done, and now our variant is all set up. Step 2 is to tell Optimize under which conditions this test should run. So it's already got that URL we put in earlier, but I'm gonna change this slightly because we want to test this new nav bar across all pages of the site. So instead of matches, let's change this to starts with. You can specify which audience you want this test to run on based on data from Google Analytics, like what device they're using or where they're located. But again, we just want to test with all users, so we'll just leave this on the default. A little pro tip here, you can also add more pages so that you can test specific flows or funnels. Okay, now Optimize knows when to run the experiment. Let's give this test a description. Something to help us and our teammates remember what the test is about, even long after it's archived. Things like the overall goal and what the hypothesis is and any useful background info. Relatedly, we're gonna tell Optimize what to measure. This is basically the rules of the game. It decides what variant wins. This is really important. It's the whole reason that we're doing this test in the first place, to see if our changes affect this goal. You'll remember our overall goal here is to increase the session times of users. So let's add one here. I'm going to choose from their pre-populated list. And we have a couple of options here, but I'm just going to click session duration. Let's add an additional objective too. This is not going to have any effect on which variant is the winner. It's just going to track it for us kind of in the background while the main test is running. Let's pick page views because that's very closely tied to session time. And we're kind of curious about whether or not this experiment will affect that as well, especially considering that we're adding more links to the nav. In step 4, we're just gonna make sure the logistics are ready to go by checking whether or not Optimize is installed properly, and then select whether or not we want email notifications, what percentage of traffic we wanna go through the experiment, and usually you want this to be at 100%, and set the activation event or when the experiment is triggered. Okay, for the last step, we're gonna scroll back to the top and get the test going. Usually you want your A/B test to run for at least 2 weeks, maybe up to 90 days, so that the test has enough data to give you a good indication of which variant is actually the winner. Optimize lets you schedule a test for whatever time you want in the future, but we're ready to go, so we're just gonna click start. And there you go, it's started. Our experiment is running on our podcast app now. So here on the reporting tab, we got some stats up at the top telling us what the traffic was like and how many tests were run, how many sessions were run. Then down here, we have the results of the experiment itself. So you'll see that we're looking at our main objective of session duration, but you can also switch to your secondary objective. This table shows us the variance and what data has been gathered via the experiment. And then over here, Optimize shows us its analysis of this data, basically how probable it is that each variant would be the winner. I think the easiest number to look at here is probability to be best. So in our case, the original has a 12% chance to be the winner, and the new variant has 88%. And this graph down at the bottom just shows us how each variant performed over time. So our variant performed better than the original, but not by a whole lot. And that's fine. Sometimes you won't get a really clear conclusion from your test, which just usually tells you to keep testing. And these results make us wonder if bigger changes to the nav would have a bigger impact on the test. We've got a couple ideas in mind, and so we decide to do another test, but this time we're going to do a multivariate test. A multivariate test is very similar to an A/B test, but instead of just testing one thing, we're going to test a combination of several things. Let me show you what I mean. So we've started our second test and made sure it was a multivariate test. You'll see the variance section looks a little different from the last time we did this. We've got two sections here, so I'm gonna go in and create the first variant. And what we're doing this time is we're pulling all of those sublinks out and just putting them in groups so that they're all visible all the time. In the second section, we're gonna add a search bar. Now that we've got all that set up, let's look at the combinations tab. You'll see here that what this test is gonna do is take the originals and the variants that we've created and put them all together in different combinations so that it can figure out which combination performs the best with our goal of increased session times. You can see in this combination, for example, it's got the original from section A and the variant from section B, which looks like this. Okay, let's quickly finish setting this experiment up. It's all the same kind of stuff as before, and let Optimize do its thing. All right, the results from our multivariate test came in. Let's see what happened. As we can see here, a combination of all of the variants is the interface that leads with the best session times, and it's by quite a good margin too. So we have our winner. Now we can confidently go back to our design team with concrete evidence and move forward with a new navigation design, knowing that it's very likely to increase session times and page views on our podcast app. And we figured all of this out for free and with a pretty easy setup when it comes to A/B tests. A sitemap is another really important tool when it comes to navigation. And in the very first Designer's Toolkit video we ever made, we talked about how to use Miro to make a sitemap. Check out that video right here, and you can subscribe to see more of Designer's Toolkit Season 1 coming soon.